and welcome back to World Osprey Week. Thanks for joining us again to discover more about ospreys. Today we're learning about the history of ospreys in the UK and why it's so important to understand their history in order to protect them in the future. As we learned in the last video, there are now more than 300 osprey nests in the UK, with most of them in Scotland. However, ospreys used to be widespread all across the UK, as well as in Western Europe. So what's caused their population, that is the number of ospreys, to decline? Let's turn back the clock to 1847. Across the UK, as well as much of Western Europe, osprey numbers have been going down for many years. This was because of people. Unlike today, there was no World Osprey Week to celebrate birds of prey like ospreys, and many people did not like them. This was because they saw birds of prey as a threat to the animals that they owned, their food sources, and their livelihoods. This meant that people would intentionally kill ospreys and other birds of prey, which damaged their population numbers. And this was not the only reason that their population suffered. At the same time, people also enjoyed collecting wildlife specimens, including eggs, for personal collections and museums. This means that ospreys were killed for these collections, and people stole their eggs from their nests before they could even hatch. This was really bad for birds of prey, and in 1847, the last pair of ospreys in England were shot in Somerset, making them extinct as a breeding bird in England, having already been gone from Wales and Northern Ireland. They lasted a bit longer in Scotland, but by 1916, their numbers were so low that they were considered to be extinct as a breeding bird in the whole of the UK. Now that's the worst part over. It starts to get better when we skip to 1954, when a pair of ospreys returned to Scotland and set up a nesting territory at Loch Garten near Inverness. So we know that people had previously treated ospreys badly, so telling people that there was a nest was a massive risk at the time, but the RSPB thought that getting people to help protect the nest was better than hiding it from them. And it worked. This was called Operation Osprey, and it involved 24-hour-a-day monitoring of the nest to protect the birds and their eggs. You might be thinking that having volunteers protecting one nest all the way through the night seems a bit over the top. But at the time, egg collectors were still at large and ospreys were now incredibly rare, meaning that their eggs were worth even more. With the amazing effort made to protect the nests, the osprey population grew year on year. But it wasn't an easy ride. They had a big egg problem. As well as egg collectors still stealing the rare osprey eggs, there were also issues being caused by a pesticide known as DDT. Pesticides are often used to kill insects that eat or affect the quality of plants and crops. However, DDT, as well as other pesticides, was particularly bad at damaging other things too. It managed to get into the food chain of many birds of prey and cause the thinning of their eggshells, which sadly meant that many chicks never hatched. But in 1972, DDT was banned, and as egg collectors were given harsher punishments for their crimes, the osprey population began to grow with more speed. By the 1990s, there were more than 60 pairs in Scotland, thanks to the help of people dedicated to protecting them, but there were still no pairs in England or Wales. So they were given a helping hand. In 1996, an osprey reintroduction project took place at Rutland Water in the East Midlands, led by the Leicestershire and Rutland Wildlife Trust, Anglican Water, and osprey expert Roy Dennis. This involved moving young ospreys from Scotland down to Rutland and releasing them, which is something we'll learn more about later in the week. This project led to the first breeding pair of ospreys at Rutland in 2001, which just so happened to be the same year that another pair bred in the Lake District. This meant there were two pairs of ospreys breeding in England in 2001. The Rutland project also helped ospreys spread to Wales, where there are now a number of breeding pairs. And there is now another reintroduction project taking place in Poole on the south coast of England. With pairs now across Wales, England and Scotland, the population has recovered really well, which wouldn't have been possible without the hard work of people who really care about them. This is why it's so important for you to understand the history of ospreys in the UK, so that you can help to protect them for years to come. So that's the recent history of ospreys in the UK. We hope you found it interesting. You can discover more in our activity pack, and make sure to check back in tomorrow to learn all about osprey migration. Thanks for watching.